first thing we need to do is make sure everyone can hear me. Okay. Yes? Well, welcome to the Council's annual meeting. Councillors, are there any declarations of interest? Thank you. Before I make my announcements, I have received the following apologies for this evening's meeting. Councillor George Davis, Councillor Christine Squiggs, Councillor Tony Cox, Councillor Pat Cleary, and Councillor Les Rowlands. Are there any further apologies? We're moving on to Mayor's announcements now. And the first thing I want to say, though I doubt there is anyone in this room who doesn't know about it, is to congratulate our fabulous Tranmere Rovers Football Club for their return. I said last year we were all very proud of our football club, but now we're all super proud of you. And I know that Mark and Nicola Palios are here, I think, somewhere this evening. Lovely to see you. Congratulations to you. It certainly doesn't seem like a year ago that we were all here for Mayor Making 2017, and Bill and I were setting out on what has been a most wonderful year. I must begin with very grateful thanks to those who have worked so hard to ensure that it has been a memorable year, run on time, and been coordinated with precision. Sue Carroll, our Civic Services Officer, provides outstanding support to the mayoralty. Quiet, self-effacing and super efficient, she is the key coordinator of all things mayoral. And our sincere thanks go to you, Sue, for the work you have done for us and you do year on year for the mayoralty. Thanks also to Sonia, who works alongside Sue. I also want to say a big thanks to Carol Jackson and Barbara Turner, who both work year on year for the Mayor's charity. Your support has been greatly appreciated, as has that of our two super charities, Incubabies and Max, who threw themselves into fundraising with great enthusiasm, enabling us to fulfil our aim to help to give children the best start in life. Prior to his retirement from the council in September last year, we were driven around by Nick Greenleaves. I was Nick's 23rd mayor, and our thanks go to him for his great service, and we wish Nick a long and happy retirement. The current mayoral attendant, Paul Stead, has been a seamless replacement, and we thank Paul for his many kindnesses and services to us, and wish him well going forward. We also want to thank our cadets, Chloe Ewart and Tom Grattan, here with us this evening, who have so ably supported us on civic occasions, and wish them well with their studies and their future careers. Our grateful thanks must also go to the Deputy Mayor and Mayoress, Geoffrey and Anne Watt. Their support and friendship has been tremendous, as has your coverage of so many engagements. It has been a busy year, which has seen Bill and I complete just around 400 engagements. You'll be pleased to hear that I'm not going to give you a rundown of all of them this evening, but I will touch on our highlights. We've had the pleasure of meeting Princes Edward, William and Andrew on separate occasions. A great privilege. We've had our very poignant moments here. The posthumous freedom of the borough being given to the 96 Hillsborough fans. A huge civic event for our borough. The Prime Minister was with us for the unveiling of the memorial to PC David Phillips. Another very moving occasion. We've honoured our military heroes by unveiling memorials at Woodside and Seacombe promenades to the Cockleshell Heroes and Sergeant Jack Potter, and commemorating the 100th anniversary of the raid on Zeebrugge, and of course our annual remembrance service, honouring all the boroughs war dead. Children have played a big role in our year. We've held a mayoral celebration of spiritual, moral, social and cultural values in our school, attended here in the Civic Hall by over 20 schools. We vouchers to our primary school children, visited scout and guide packs, and observed at first hand just how many great activities and achievements our young people are involved in. We've had great pleasure in raising green flags with primary school children to celebrate their eco credentials, a very heartwarming experience. We have also been amazed, as I know all mayors are, by the hundreds, if not thousands, of volunteers from across many diverse communities who give their time to help our young people, help other people, and help our senior citizens. We have a borough to be very proud of. We have also former citizens to be proud of, and we have had the honour of unveiling blue plaques to four of them. Charles Dawson Brown, who set up and preserved for posterity a museum in the grounds of St. Bridget's Church in West Kirby. James Gillespie Graham, the wonderful architect who designed Hamilton Square. Anne Davison, the first woman to sail single-handedly across the Atlantic, who lived at Mirbrook House in Thornton Hoof. And Mary Ann Mercer, the first woman mayor of Birkenhead and first woman alderman. It has been a whirlwind year at times, but it has been a great honour and privilege to be mayor of our borough. In closing, my final thanks must go to Bill, my husband, and consort for always being there for me at my side throughout it all. And I promise we will have a rest now, dear. Well, for a little while anyway. Thank you.
Her support and dedication is also therefore recognised this evening. Having served as Commodore of the Hoylake Sailing Club and following the arrival of their two children, he accepted in 1999 the nomination for the former Royden Award, covering then Greasby, Frankby, Newton and Grange, which he represented for a single term before returning for the new West Kirby and Thurstiston Ward, which includes Caldy, Grange and Newton, and where he has been re-elected on three further occasions. Geoffrey has been an assiduous local councillor, dealing with the inquiries from his residents in a way that has earned him their respect and thanks, most of which goes unrecognised by the wider public. He has never been at the back of the queue when it comes to campaigning and has supported his colleagues, myself included, at most, if not all, elections. For the past year, he has served as your deputy, proudly wearing the chain of the former Hoylake Urban District Council. Here at the Town Hall, Geoffrey is perhaps best known for acting as my group spokesman and twice chairman of the Pensions Committee, overseeing the investment and administration of the Merseyside Pension Fund, whose assets have grown in his time from under £3 billion to more than £8 billion and is now fully funded. He was also the inaugural chairman of the original Wirral West Area Forum. Madam Mayor, as many of us who will have sat near him will testify, Councillor Watt is also one of the few councillors who does not need a microphone to ensure that his voice is heard. Outside politics, he has maintained his lifelong enthusiasm for sailing in the opera-class boats moored at Wirral, and latterly has found time supporting Caldy Rugby Club playing at Patton Field in his ward. Indeed, Madam Mayor, Councillor Watt's influence is found not only in sailing and rugby, but as we've seen this weekend with Tranmere Rovers. I'm not quite sure how the Deputy Mayor has ensured that result, but it is a fantastic start to our borough's municipal year. Madam Mayor, the Conservative Group is supporting Geoffrey's nomination for Mayor, not only because of the time he has served since those heady days in Upton 30 years ago, but also out of respect for his consistent support for his residents and the fact that he is a good and decent man who, along with Anne, will be assets as our Mayor and Mayoress and an excellent first citizen representing our borough to others. Madam Mayor, I move that Councillor Geoffrey Watt be elected Mayor of the Metropolitan Borough of Wirral.
It's my pleasure to second the proposition, and obviously I wish Geoffrey and Anne all the best for the new municipal year. I'm sure they'll do an excellent job. And may I just use this opportunity, Madam Mayor, of thanking you and Bill as our outgoing retiring mayor for the wonderful year that you've had together. I think you've been a credit to the borough. So thank you very much. Thank you.
In the absence of any other nominations, I declare that Councillor Geoffrey